could leave. I came in here for a special offer, guaranteed personality. I wasn't born so much as I fell out. Nobody seemed to notice me. We had a hedge back home in the suburb, over which I never could see. I heard the people who live on the ceiling scream and fight more scarily. Hearing that noise was my first ever feeling. That's how it's been all around me. I'm all lost in the supermarket. I can no longer shop happily. I came in here for a special offer, a guaranteed personality.
Good day, everyone. This is your favorite neighborhood chef, G-Rod, once again for another segment of Cooking Tips with G-Rod, presented to you by The Gathering in association with the Donato Family Productions. Today, we are going to talk about knife skills. It's something we all take for granted, but learning how to use a knife correctly in the kitchen can make life a little bit easier for you. First off, we're going to start off with your cutting board. Others have wood at home, and this is plastic, but there's a big controversy, but that's for another segment. What you should do is take a wet rag, a damp rag, put it on the bottom. Put your cutting board on it. Your cutting board now doesn't move. You have a secure place to work. Now we will go through the knives that everyone has in their kitchen. The first one we have here is the cleaver. If you have this in your kitchen, please do me a favor and toss it in the garbage. The only reason you would have one of these if a family member is a serial killer, and the way that works, family is always the last to know. We don't need that. This is a boning knife, which is another item we should not have. We would have no desire to bone a leg of lamb or to bone a ham. These two items, please, we will use to the professionals up at Brennan's Meat, Glitters, Izzo, Izzy, and John Lombardi. Then we have the paring knife, which is a great utility knife. It is also called the utility knife. It is one knife that you should have in your kitchen. Then there is the bread knife, which every Italian American will have at home, because what Italian American does not eat bread. Then we have the chef's knives, which is, or a French knife in other words, but in America here we call it the chef's knife. This is a Japanese chef's knife, which the Japanese use it if they prefer this one over the standard chef knife. And there is, of course, the chef's knife, which I go to the Anthony Bourdain School of Knife Skills. You only need one, which is a good chef knife. A sharp chef knife can cut anything in your kitchen. Back to the paring knife, which is great to pare out the core of a tomato, which you see. It's good for. But if you have a good chef knife, you can do the same thing. Once again, eliminating a knife from your closet. Okay. The knife, which we would like to hold it on a 45 degree angle on your cutting board. If you end up doing this with your knife to chop things, you're doing it completely wrong. Your knife will always remain on the cutting board. If you stick the tip always on the cutting board, you cannot go wrong. You will hold the knife like so. Some people like to put their index finger up here to give the knife more security, which I do myself. If you take it and move it in a circular motion with your arm straight, You should cut everything nice and evenly. Now when you take things, you are not gonna cut something like this with your fingers exposed. Take it, hold the item with your two fingers in the middle, your claw, your pinky and index finger on the ends to secure it for yourself. This way it doesn't go anywhere. And once again, on a 45 degree angle, in a circle of motion, you'll see, as I do that, you are pushing the food into the knife. That is the trick. And you would try to come up with evenly pieces, because the trick to having stuff even is they cook evenly. We don't want something like, as I did, thick like this, and then want something smaller than if you ever had chili in life and saw how people just went like this with peppers. Some peppers are big, some are small, and they end up, the bigger pieces end up not cooking. So the trick is to get everything evenly done. Speed, don't worry about speed. Speed will come over time. Your biggest thing is to cut things evenly and to leave the knife on the cutting board. Once you get that, speed will come. Now, we were just talking about cutting an onion and a piece of garlic. These are things that I feel people should know. Once again, holding the onion in place. You would take it. Now, this is a longer cut. I would need two cuts to go through this, because it is high. It's called a high cut. Once again, I would do it with the other side. I would do this twice to get through the onion. Now, you, everyone at home, all these scraps that I'm sending, they are excellent for stock. Now, once again, holding it with a high cut, I will go through it twice. And now I have my two onions. Take the outer layer off. Always remember to take, there's a little membrane, a skin that you would see on the onion sometimes. Just get that away, that will make your knife slip. Now, everyone would begin to cut an onion this way, which is that is cutting against the grain. Where you made the cut, you will not continue cutting there. That's what makes your eyes tear. The gas is on the onion release because you're cutting against the grain. If you cut the onion this way, you are cutting with the grain of the onion, like so. My knife on a 45 degree angle, but my tip still on the cutting board. In a circular motion, and when you get to this part, the onion now becomes a little unsturdy on you. If you flip it over, now you have, once again, a flat surface. Using the claw, you have your two fingers in place, in a circular motion, pushing the onion towards the knife. Not the knife, towards the onion. And you would end up, once again, with evenly cut pieces, which will cook evenly for you. Now, one other thing about the onion, they end up chopping, which a knife should never be chopped, as I always said. Circular motion. You take your onion to the edge of your cutting board, you cut slices into it, and then once again, in the opposite direction, you cut more slices. With your eye, see how evenly they are. Your onion will have cuts in either direction now. You just take it, and once again, your knife on the cutting board, circular motion. And there you have a small diced onion. All your pieces are evenly diced. Simplest way to dice an onion without, once again, chopping, which is a cardinal sin with a chef knife. And also, when you need to scrape, please do not, this dulls your knife. Do not scrape like this. Scrape with the opposite end of the knife with the blade standing up, upright. Now, a piece of garlic is the same concept as the onion. You would just cut it into slices as thinly as you want it. And then, once again, in circular motions, There you go. You dice your you dice your dog in nice small dices without chopping on the cutting board. Once again, to sum up, as I always do, the bone and knife and the cleaver, leave it to the professionals, please. You can use a Japanese chef knife, which is very good, but us in America like to use standard American chef knife. Bread knife, sherry knife, the twin knife that, yes, we all need in our house. Utility pare knife, yes. I suggest everyone has one, but me, I do everything with a chef knife. As you can see, a good chef knife, a sharp one, I can cut through bread. I don't need a bread knife to do that. And also, I can cut through a tomato with it. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you soon.